Hi students, a very pleasant and warm greetings to you all. Hope you are doing good. Last session we have seen about computer ethics and cyber security, right? So we have seen the introduction about internet and the communication media, and also we have seen the guidelines of ethics and ethical issues, right? In ethical issues we saw about cyber crime, software piracy, hacking, use of computers to commit fraud. And also we have seen some of the viruses and making false claims using computer, right? So today we are going to see a recap of yesterday's portion, and we are going to move on to software piracy chapter, right? So last session itself we have seen about the crimes which are done using this computer and internet, right? Malware means it is a malicious program that can perform a variety of functions including activity without their permission, right? The activities which is done in someone's computer without their permission is known as malware. And harvesting and spam also we have seen. Harvesting is a person or a program who collects the login information, that is the login ID or the password, from a legal user in a illegal way. We'll say it is harvesting. And spam, we saw that it is distributing the unwanted email to a large number of internet users, right? And today we are going to see about software piracy. Okay, software piracy is the unauthorized copying of software. They have given a diagrammatic representation of this software piracy. Software piracy means it is of two sections. First one is duplicating and selling the copyrighted programs, and then another one is downloading software illegally through network, right? Here software piracy has been divided into two. The first one is duplicating and selling copyrighted programs. That is, one person will have created a program and it is his program, right? The owner only has the copyright of that. If someone else is using that, someone else is duplicating and selling those copyrighted program, that is the first section in this software piracy. And the other one is downloading the software illegally using internet. That is the another section in this software piracy. Okay, here software piracy means it is entirely a different approach of software piracy, is called the shareware. Okay, shareware publishers will encourage the users to give the copies of the program to their friends or to their colleagues, but they will ask everyone who uses that program regularly to pay a registration fees. That means the fees they have to pay to the program's author directly. This shareware will contact one person, means that person will be able to use that program, right? So that program, this shareware will ask you to share it with your friends or your colleagues, right? After some days, when you are using that program, it will ask you to pay the registration fees for the program which you are using. So this is the approach of shareware. This is also a software piracy technique. And here if you see commercial programs that are made available to the public illegally, we'll say it as wares. This is also important to mark, wares. A commercial program which is made available to the public illegally. That means if a program is there and if it is made public in an illegal way, we'll say it as wares, right? And the next one is hacking. The word hacking is familiar to you, right? Do you know the right meaning of hacking? Hacking means it is intruding into a computer system to steal the personal data without the owner's permission or without the knowledge of the owner. It's like a stealing a password, right? So this process is called hacking. Okay, it is also gaining the unauthorized access to a computer system and alerting its contents. That means if you are trying to go inside another one person's personal computer, or if you are trying to steal a person's data, or if you are trying to use someone else's password without their permission, it will come under hacking, right? Here, this is also the gaining unauthorized access to a computer system and alerting its contents. So, if a person is having a personal data in a computer and if you are trying to hack it or if you are trying to steal it, it will come under hacking, right? This may be done to have a criminal activity, or this may be done as a hobby also, or some will be having interest to steal some other's password or some other's details from a computer. This all will come under hacking, right? This may be a hobby, or this some people may consider it as a criminal activity also. This hacking may be harmless if the hacker is only enjoying the challenge of breaking the systems or breaking the defenses. But some of the hacking will be some practiced as a ethical, non-ethical one. In that case, it will be considered as a severe crime, right? So here, this hacking is harmless till you do this, or till you take this challenge in breaking the systems or breaking some codings. If you involve in someone else's privacy, it becomes a crime, right? This hacking also has been represented in a diagrammatic manner. Let's see the diagrammatic representation of hacking. The act of gaining illegal access to a computer is called hacking, right? So this is protected by firewalls, passwords and user IDs, anti-hacking softwares and all, right? The act of this gaining illegal access to a computer will lead to the identity theft or gaining personal information. What will happen when hacking is done? The access of a computer will be in the hands of an illegal person, right? The illegal access will be gained by a criminal, and it leads to the identity theft, or our details or personal stuffs will be stolen by someone, and our personal informations may be shared with someone else. This is the main process in this hacking, and this can be protected by firewalls, by using some passwords or user IDs, anti-hacking softwares and all can be used for protecting this hacking, right? To prevent this unauthorized access, intrusions detection system, that is IDS, this is virus and content scanner patches and hot fixes are used here in hacking to prevent this unauthorized access. Firewalls, this IDS is nothing but intrusions detection system, virus and content scanners, patches, hot fixes, these are all used to prevent this hacking process, right? Next session we'll see about cracking. Before that, learn this cracking and the cyber crime activities. Make sure you are clear with this software piracy and hacking before we move on to the cracking section, right? Thank you for your valuable time. Stay home, stay safe, take care, bye.